studio. When I'm not rapping, when I'm not acting, and when I'm not DJing, I'm watching the number one show, UFM.
How you doing today? We're here. I'm DeMarco, Urban Flavor Television. I'm here with the people that put the magazine XXL together. You know what I'm saying? One, and here we have Jay-Z, and then we have a Master P, and we're going to talk about and find out why that happened and find out more about the magazine. We're going to start here with my left, and we're going to go to my right, introducing your names and your position, of course.
I'm Reggie Dennis. I'm the editor-in-chief.
I'm Todd Barbie, retail sales director.
My name is James Bernard. I'm the executive editor.
Okay. Well, let's just start out like XXL. Why XXL? Why even, you know, even put it to like a measurement? Can we just hit off on that first?
Well, the cool thing about magazines, and maybe the most difficult part, is coming up with a name. So we wanted something that really stood out, something that wasn't corny, something that wouldn't get played out as the years went on. And, you know, when we heard the name XXL, it just invokes so much, you know, especially about hip-hop, being larger than life, being bigger than you, being the best. And it fit us, it fit the magazine, it fits our direction. And it's something that you won't forget once you see it on the newsstands, and it's a really cool logo.
Yeah, that's true. Now, why Master P and Jay-Z on one issue? Like, was it just because it was a premiere issue, or why?
It was different. You know, we wanted to get, I think if you look at it in terms of, you know, hip-hop, you want to give props to as many people as you can. I think if you look at it in terms of business, I know, I think that, you know, in hip-hop, you know, if you split the cover, you can probably, you know, target more to different regions and stuff.
Okay. So this is, was it just for the premiere issue, because this was the premiere issue, or will this happen every time for every
I think
every
we'll
issue?
Just depends on the issue. It's going to change all the time. We might do three covers. Who knows? You know, we might do. You know, in a situation, we can try anything we want. So, you know, we might try it.
Yeah, it's all about establishing a presence. You know, we're coming out as a new magazine. We need to have people talking about it. So if you have two different covers, it looks like it's two magazines out simultaneously.
Right. Mm-hmm.
If you don't like Jay-Z, you might like Master P and vice versa. And, you know, we were fortunate to get two really good cover quality shots, so why not give people their props? You know, you have Master P who's selling millions of records down south. You have Jay-Z who's about to really be the king of rap.
Oh, so, definitely. No diggity. So what market are you trying to capture? I mean, is there an exact market? Are you just, like, feeling your way out right now?
Depends on who you're talking to. If we're talking to an advertiser, I would say one thing. If we're talking to you, I would say another thing. So what do you want to hear?
Well, I'm asking you, what market are you trying to...
I mean, I think that everybody should be XXL. I mean, I think that, you know, XXL is a magazine that, like, you know, basically everybody who's black between 18 and 40 should definitely, like, read it. You know, should definitely read it. But I think there are going to be a lot of people, you know, I think that the magazine, you know, has a lot of qualities to it that a lot of people can respect. And so I think that, you know, I don't know. I would just say that our audiences we're going for is everybody.
There's definitely room for everyone, because, like, my mother picked it up, and she, like, read the Ray Charles article and was, like, open to that. There's not a lot of, like, magazines that claim to be hip-hop magazines or hip-hop influence magazines that are doing stuff on, like, home education, a group like The Seekers. Like, it's just a lot of stuff in there that people in that age demographic would be interested in, but it's, like, a lot of these magazines, like, tend to ignore, you know, like the intelligent or intellectual
exactly.
side
I mean,
of
that. You know,
we're trying to say that you can be hip-hop and still be intelligent.
Now, when you talk about advertising, when you're selling it to advertisers, I mean, am I going to see, like, Versace in these ads and, like, you know, Land Rovers? I mean, stuff that, like I don't know, like, hip-hop people...
I hope so.
I mean, you are?
I mean, I hope so. Yeah, I mean, I think that you know, yeah. Why? Is there a problem?
No, I just know, you know what I'm saying? Because, like, you know, I pick up other magazines, and I see a lot of different advertisements as far as, like, Versace Couture and, you know, as far as, like, Todd Oldham and stuff like that's really expensive that I just wanted to know, you know, would you be targeting the same market?
I mean, I think you'll see a range, but I don't think that, like, it's a bad thing to have those ads in there.
Oh shit, that's the rave one is, man.
Universal Will is Mine in Miami, baby. And I wanted to just take a moment to say that I wanted to announce to all of New York that me and Jennifer Lopez are engaged now. And this is a song that we got engaged to, and that's why I'm listening to it and I'm enjoying it. You know, just thinking about her, you know, I feel like we're really in love, you know. So I just wanted to announce that to everybody and also say that I'm happy to be in Miami. Right now we're in between Miami and Orlando. We're gonna go to Universal Studios. That's where we do the that's where we'll do some real filming.
Here we are, South Beach, Florida. It's about 6 o'clock and everybody's gone from the beach now, but we still have some honeys over here. Let's take a look. What do you think? Very nice, very nice. Look at that, a whole pile of them.
We've had all of them.
Yeah, we just finished going swimming with those girls. And, I don't know, it looks like all the other girls
are in the water.
We've impregnated them and they've all rushed off to...
As you can see behind me, there's fine specimens remaining.
Now turn sideways, turn your head sideways, and open your mouth. Go a little lower, go a little lower. Now, do it again, do it again. Very good, very good. How was that? How did that taste?
That tasted great. That's what we like.
They have lots of good food out here.
There's a thing Ponce de Leon used to search for called Uke Juice.
Right.
And there it is, and it was just in my mouth.
We need to go talk to them.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. What do you think their names are?
Let's see. Television audience, what do you think their name is?
First, let's talk about...
I think...
this one. What do you think her name is?
I think Lissette. And
what about this one?
Cynthia.
This is the finger of God. What is your name, little human?
So that's what the television audience believes their name is.
Okay.
So we'll soon find out.
What was it again?
Lissette and Cynthia.
Cynthia, okay.
Yeah, sure.
Now we're gonna find out. We're standing over there, and we're trying to guess your name.
Sarah.
It's Sarah, and what's your name?
June.
June. Are you guys related?
Yeah.
You look like it, I can tell. So, you guys live in Miami?
No.
No?
Yeah.
In New York?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're from New York, too. What part of New York?
Where do you live?
Uptown. Hey, what about you? Oh, yeah? What part of Westchester? Yonkers? I used to live in, I go to SUNY Purchase. Yeah. Okay. Say hello.
Hello.
It's going to be on Manhattan Cable.
And we're back. Yeah, with the members of XXL making it happen. You know, one with Jay-Z, one with Master P. All right, fellas, I mean, when selling it to advertisers, Matt, well, you know, since we're talking about advertisers, when selling it to the advertisers, I mean, how difficult was it really to say, well, you know, we're calling from a hip-hop magazine or, you know, we want you to advertise in hip-hop. Were they just saying, oh, another hip-hop magazine, another one, you know, I mean, what was their reaction?
I think the reaction was pretty good because we did a premiere issue, I mean, a preview issue.
Mm-hmm.
And that, you know, it should have showed what we could do. It didn't have any ads in it, so it was something to show advertisers, you know, look, this is going to be really different. So I don't think that, and also you got to remember, a lot of those battles, you know, thankfully have been, you know, fought and won for the first tier of things. You know, I mean, it used to be, you know, a lot of ads that a lot of these magazines have, you take for granted now, but like it would have happened like 5 years ago. But now, you know, we got to do the next level. But to an extent, it's not, you know, you're not yet, I mean, for a good, I don't know, if you think of it as territory, you can conquer like, you know, half the territory without having to answer questions about, you know, what is hip-hop and blah, blah, blah. Now, if it's when you want to get out to the frontier, when you're going to have to start doing that. And I think we're going to have to start doing that because I think that, you know, those people do have to, like Reggie said, start to think about the audience differently, or to think about it more well-roundedly. So so I think that we're going to, like, almost voluntarily, you know, start to challenge some of those things. But, you know, for this issue right now, I mean, people saw the preview issue and saw, you know, something there that was I guess people thought was special.
So it really sold itself. You really didn't have to do a lot of.
Well, you know, I didn't have to do anything because I'm an editor. So, you know, it's easy for me to talk. For all I know, those guys were putting in 14 hours a day and sweating and crying over every ad. I don't know. It looked all right. It looks easy to me. They didn't have to lay anything out.
Yeah. Well, how long actually did it take from someone saying, I want to start a new magazine, to actually it coming out to the press? I mean, how long approximately did that take?
Well, I mean, it depends.
The long story, 7 years. Right, the short story.
Depends on which part of the story, you know, you want to hear.
I just want to briefly just like go through, like somebody walked in the office and said, because this is from Harris Publications, right?
Yeah, but see, it's different. It's, you know, you can't just do that because remember we have a past, you know, and Harris Publications has a past, not as deep as ours into this market and this music, but they've done they have their own story. I mean, one day they want, but this whole thing is like you can't really sum it up in a story. What this coming out cannot be summarized in any sort of like short story that would be good for television.
Okay. But I'm saying, I mean, who came to who to say I want to start another magazine? I mean, did you guys come from a different like magazine to come to this magazine?
Well, we came
from, you know, almost 3 years ago. We left The Source after being there, you know, 4 or 5 years, respectively.
Both of you, or three of you, at The Source, or just you
we
by yourself?
We were all at The Source.
Oh, all of you at The Source, and you were like, I want to take it to another level, and so you came to, you went to Harris Publications.
Well, we took some time off for the idea to cook, you know, and percolate, you know. But then the thing that happened with Harris is a whole other story. I mean, that sort of just happened. And once Harris happened, you know, this is certainly much different publication than they expected to put out. So, you know, it's really not like a really, you know, it's not a real simple story. It takes, you know, really, you know, for a magazine like this, like the sense of so much of it depends on our chemistry and our sensibility that, like, you know, it took years of just, like, getting to know people, you know, and having a dry run. I mean, a source... You know, I mean, Reggie used to say right after we left, the source was a blueprint, you know, or the first draft, you know. And so we had a chance to grow and do something different now, and it's, you know, it's really exciting. But
it was good to know every aspect of the business and learn about publishing, to learn about retail, and to really have a, you know, a magazine like The Source, which was really so in tune with the communities and you really get a lot of immediate feedback. And we took all of that, looked at our mistakes, mm-hmm. and, you know, with the XXL, we were able to just come together, you know, with a few more years of maturity behind us, and really do something that sets us apart from everything else that's out there. And when you look at, you know, other magazines, they're kind of repeating the same patterns, the same cycles.
Okay.
They're trying to be the king of hip-hop. We're trying to be the king of magazines.
Okay.
You know,
right.
XXL is the greatest magazine that's out there, and that's what we're trying to do.
So you're taking it to another level, and that's kind of like the goal of the magazine, just to take magazine to the next level?
Yeah, pushing the envelope. You know, try to do something that's like people are going to remember. You know, something worth picking up.
Right. Hip-hop is so dynamic as an art form and as a culture and as a means of expression. Why don't the magazines that cover hip-hop even showcase a fraction of that creative energy? And, you know, a hip-hop magazine should change the way you look at magazines. It should change the way you look at publishing. Just the way hip-hop music has changed the music industry, it's changed everything. You know, I think, you know, hip-hop is so powerful that anything it touches, it'll just mutate and use to its own ends. So, you know, I definitely want a magazine like XXL to say, wow, you know, I want people to be like, man, you know, they really changed the way I look at magazines, and, you know, maybe I should try to pursue a career in journalism or publishing, because, you know, we have a lot of stories to tell. And when I go to a magazine store, I want to see a lot of magazines with people who look like me on the cover.
Right. Okay.
Good magazines that look like me on the cover, not
magazines of substance.
Right.
But that's what you have, a magazine of substance, but you just like portray it through hip hop. But this is not just a music magazine, as you said before. It has news stories.
Right.
It has an overlook on life. I mean, it's really
a whole lifestyle. I mean, I like to call it more hip hop influence, because like in the last 20 years, like the biggest influence on cultural, black culture anyway, has been hip hop.
Mm-hmm.
So it's everything is just an offshoot of that. And it was always there, just call it influence, whether it was bebop or blues or whatever. And right now, the dominant culture is just hip hop, but it's more than just music. You know,
mm-hmm.
There are people on Wall Street who listen to hip hop, and
that's
it's
true.
Influence on their minds. And like KRS had something that I thought was rather profound. Like, there's a president of the United States, a future president of the United States, somewhere listening to, if not my album, somebody's hip hop album,
exactly.
And he's probably right. So it's a lot of positive energy that's coming from this culture that I think is kind of being ignored by some of the dominant publications.
And also, I don't even think of this as really, you know, in the same way that an album is a statement that contributes to hip hop. Like we're trying to make, this magazine is a statement that we're making that will contribute to hip hop. It does more than just cover it. You know, it adds to hip hop. You know, we're trying to add to the culture. And you know, that's why, you know, when I slipped up before and I said, you know, the album. But like, you think about it like that, because it's our, you know, we're trying to. This is what hip hop is. This is what one little corner, one way of looking at this whole thing looks like to us. This is what's in our worldview. So you know, everything in there, you know, is held together by like one, you know, I mean, a common thread. You know, which is hip hop.
But that's all right. We're gonna come back. We have to take a break. You know. Somebody got to pay the bills around here.
Mm.
And then we're going to come back and we're going to finish up with the team of XXL. All right, so stick around.
Hello.
Hi.
What's your name? Hello. No one.
Huh?
Where are you guys from?
Jersey.
Jersey, where are you from?
Jersey.
Yeah, what part of Jersey? Yeah. There are a lot of people from, not from Miami, who are here, right?
So, like New York.
Right, like me.
You're from New York?
Uh-huh. So how you like Miami?
I like it.
Yeah, why?
I like the sun.
Do you? Why do you like the sun? Because you get a nice tan.
I like the sun.
They have better sun here than they do in New York, don't they?
Yeah.
What part of Jersey, you said?
Linden.
Yeah. We do a cable show in Manhattan.
Video cable?
Yeah. We do a cable show in Manhattan, and we just thought we'd talk to some people and see what they think about Miami.
What cable show?
It's called UFM.
So if I watch
the
cable show in Manhattan, that would be on it?
In Manhattan, and in Brooklyn, too.
We're going to be on it.
And pretty soon it's going to be down here, too. What do you think about that? What do you guys do while you're here? Clubbing?
Yeah, everything.
Clubbing.
Get drunk.
Yeah?
Drunk.
What?
Clubbing, eating, tanning.
How many days have you been here?
A week. I got here Thursday.
And you're leaving today?
I'm leaving tomorrow.
Tomorrow? And when are you leaving?
Friday.
Very nice, very nice. Okay, what's your name? What?
Tiffany.
And what's your name?
Michelle.
Very nice to meet you. My name is Christian.
Hi.
Say goodbye.
We're just practicing. Later on, we're gonna go hunting for crooked cops. You got paid.
This is a 40 caliber Smith & Wesson.
Buck 'em down, buck down.
Universal Coquilla's mind, this could be you.
Okay, one more final question. Double XL, year 2000, what do you see?
Number one magazine on the newsstands.
In the world.
Something that sets the trends that people look to for news, entertainment, politics, whatever. Something historical, and by the year 2000, the foundation will be laid so we can go for like, you know, 40, 50 years with this.
Are you, you're overseas already? I mean, you're overseas already. Mm-hmm. I mean, everything's in place. What is the circulation actually?
Well, we just started, so we'll see how this issue does, and that'll determine the circulation. But we're optimistic. We put out slightly over 500,000 copies worldwide.
Jeez, 500,000.
So it's out there, and and hopefully, you know, the covers are attractive enough, you know, to attract people.
The covers are attractive enough. These are some hot covers here. So,
and once you get beyond the covers, the editorial within the magazine should spark some debate. And hopefully, you know, people will enjoy this and want to rejoin us in the future.
Yeah. Well, we have to come to a close on this segment or this, you know, part of our show. But it's been a pleasure. And I thank you fellas for coming down here and talking in depth about XXL. And I'd just like to say from a personal standpoint, at the magazine is definitely hot. This is, you know, it's hot to death. And I'm glad that the magazine finally came out that, you know, it shows hip hop in a positive light and in a mature light, you know, and I enjoy reading it from cover to cover, and I definitely look forward to reading another issue of XXL.
Thank you.
So thanks for watching Urban Flavor Television. I'm DeMarco. Do your thing.
Fuquilism is the return of mankind to the essence of the original teachings of the hidden masters.
When you create a word, you create a way of thinking.